بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله نبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وقال الله تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a blessing upon us that we have been given the ni'mah of Islam. And the second blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us is that we are the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are the final ummah of this world. Brothers and sisters, since there will not be any prophet after the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the job of the prophecy has been given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. Respected brothers and sisters, our deen, Islam, has five pillars, and one of the most important pillars that I'm going to talk about today is Salah and the importance of Islam establishing Salah in the Masajid. Respected brothers, have we ever thought about why Allah has created us? What is the purpose of life? And what is success in dunya? These are the questions that every Muslim should ask from himself. And the answer of these questions in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Verily, I have not created the mankind and the jinn kind, but to worship me alone. Dear brothers, it's very clear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for a purpose, and the purpose is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by obeying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and getting the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the purpose of life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, O Prophet, tell these people, tell your ummah, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ. If you want to love Allah, if you want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me. So it means, if you want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get his love, and you want to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only way we have is to follow Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his teachings and his sunnah. Following Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is getting the love and affection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once we do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our sins. يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Brothers and sisters, once Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was asked by a non-Muslim, most probably a Jew, that Allah has created you, as mentioned in Quran, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah has created you to worship him alone all the times. But the non-Muslim says to Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that I see you guys, you're not worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7. I see you guys doing commerce, doing trade, doing sales, doing other chores of the life, daily life, as we non-Muslims do. So where is that you're worshiping your Lord all the times? Is it only those five times? So how beautiful Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala who responded to that question. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala who responds to that non-Muslim, he says, yes, we are performing ibadah, we are worshiping our Lord 24/7 all the times. It is because we do trade, we do commerce, we do sales, we do all the chores of the life as other people do, but we do it according to the Quran and according to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is why it is ibadah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us as an ibadah to Him. Dear brothers, halal rizq is also ibadah. If we are in search of halal rizq, it's ayn ibadah. So, how beautiful Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu responds to that non-Muslim. Which means, we need to take care of our business. We need to do our jobs. We need to find halal rizq. But doing business, doing commerce, finding halal business should not prevent us from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from following the teachings of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brothers, have you ever realized and thought about our lives and measured if we are doing and following Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the teachings of Quran, and to measure whether we're pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our daily activities, or we are away from the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If not, we need to think about it. We need to see, we need to look into our lives. Brothers and sisters, whatever you do, it should be halal. And whatever activity you do, it should not prevent you from establishing especially salah and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following upon the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers, we need to make sure our lives are not against the Quran and Sunnah. If our lives are against the Quran and Sunnah, it means we are living against the purpose of our life. The purpose of our life is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers, we can easily attain the purpose of our life if we have taqwa. What is taqwa? Taqwa is basically doing whatever is allowed to be done by Quran and Sunnah. And preventing yourself from the actions which are not allowed to be done by us, by the Quran and Sunnah. Respected brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the successful people in Quran and mentions five attributes of the successful people in Quran in Surah Al-Mu'minun. Among those five attributes of the successful people, the first one is the muttaqun, and muttaqun are those people who protect their salah and perform their salah with khushu. Hazrat Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala who says, by protecting salah means establishing salah and performing it with khushu and khudu. And khushu means connecting your souls, connecting your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while worshipping Him. Respected brothers, salah has a high importance in our life. If we take out salah from our lives, we are losing our purpose. Then there is no difference between us and the other animals. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly commands the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Ask your companions. Ask your ahl. Ahl means companions, the ummah, the people in your household. For salah, bis salah. So this is a direct command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is rahmatan lil alameen, who is Sayyidul Mursaleen, who is Imam al-Anbiya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly honors him to honor your companions, your households, to perform salah, to establish salah. So it's an indirect command to all of us. We, each one of us, are responsible for their family. كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, or كما قال. Do we ask ourselves, have we ever talked about our family members, our sisters, our brothers, our sons, our siblings, about the salah? Have we ever told them that you are performing your salah or not? Have we ever asked them? Have we ever had any discussion with them regarding establishing salah? If not, we need to do that. How we need to do that? Quran is clear. Quran has a clear indication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has everything for us clear. Has clearly mentioned everything for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. ادعو. Preach. Talk to them. إلى سبيل ربك. To the path of your Rabb. Lord. بالحكمة. With wisdom. With soft words. We don't need to do, we don't need to take, you know, stick in our hands and you know, start beating our siblings and you know, our kids and start, you know, being cruel on them that why they're not performing salah. No. This will worsen the case. So we need to talk to them with the soft words. We need to discuss with them. We need to tell them. We need to talk about the importance of salah. So our words may affect their hearts. And Allah puts hidayah in their hearts and they start establishing salah 5 times a day. Respected brothers, salah is one of the most important actions of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to see that His servants are making sujood, are making ruku to Him. He feels proud. Among the malaik, among the angels, and tells them, see my slave, he's making ruku, he's making sujood for me, and you are the ones who had an objection while I was creating Adam, alayhi salatu wassalam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is feeling proud of us when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it cannot increase Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's lordship. If you don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it can never decrease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's lordship. It is us who benefit from worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we get the pleas of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts barakah in our lives, put barakah in our businesses and everything. Dear brother, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, As-salatu mi'raj al-mu'min. Salat is the miraj of the Muslim, of the mu'min. What does miraj mean? Miraj basically means the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the only messenger who met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the arsh on one and one. And on that day, on the same night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with 5 times of a prayer so that their followers, their companions can meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one and one. With no so far and so on, any means in front of them. So brothers and sisters, when you want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perform salah. That is direct connection, direct link between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone performs 2 rak'ah of salah with khushu' al-khudu, and he swears that I swear I met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is correct, he is right. That's what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. Dear brothers, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there for us to provide, to help us, then why we are looking into dunya? Why we are running in dunya? Following upon the risk, following upon something else, to find happiness. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I am your happiness. Come to me, I'm your happiness. Brothers and sisters, meet your Lord, meet your Khaliq, meet your Raziq by performing Salah. And where should you perform Salah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Verily, the masajids are for Allah. So do not invoke anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Nur says, فِي بُيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوبِ وَالْآصَالِ. Brothers, we can pray everywhere, anywhere which is clean, and there's no whatsoever something wrong against the teachings of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where we cannot perform. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فِي بُيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ. Allah talks about His houses. The masajid are Allah's houses. Masajid has superiority on all the other places. Worship, praying is a super, or we can say, one of the most important worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this most important worship should be played, should be performed, should be done in a most important place, which is the masajid, which are the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in mosques, when Allah has honor to be raised, and that His name be mentioned therein, remember Him within them in the mornings and evenings. Dear brothers, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains the clear superiority of the masajid on all the other places. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we need to remember Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially all times, all five prayers, especially in the mornings and in the evenings. That's specifically mentioned in Quran. But evening, we can mean Asr, Maghrib, Isha and Fajr. In Sultan al-Salawat is Isha and Maghrib. Isha and Fajr. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if someone performs Salat al-Isha in Masjid with the Imam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him half night accepted reward. And then the same person, when he comes to Masjid in the morning and performs his Salah with khushu' and khudu, behind Imam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him the other half of the night ibadah accepted. Accepted. So by praying Isha and Fajr, we get a complete night's worship, although we are sleeping, although whatever we are doing, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala counts that time that as if we are worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How beautiful that is. A lot of blessings due to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam upon us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is there someone who can reap this benefit? May Allah make us from Musallum. May Allah give us taqwa. May Allah give us hidayah. May Allah give us strength to follow the teachings and to establish salah, dear brothers and sisters. Dear brothers, yes, I accept. We need to do our jobs. We need to do our business. Islam does not forbid us from doing business, from doing job, from doing whatever halal activity you do. But these activities should not prevent us from making a connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about that group of people, especially in the Quran. رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about that specific group of people. رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Those men, those people, who do business, who do commerce, who do different activities to find rizq halal. But these activities does not prevent him from remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and from establishing salah. Especially Allah has mentioned salah. وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وإيتاء الزكاة and paying زكاة. يخافون يوم تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار. Why are they doing this thing? Because they are scared. They have a fear and their heart from that day. On which day their eyes and their قلوب will be turned over. The day of judgment. They're scared from the day of judgment. That's why these activities does not prevent them from worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially establishing salah in masajid. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with the time, with the health. It is us who need to follow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and pledges, Rasulullah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pledges to enter those people to the Jannah with his own responsibility who establishes salah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. If the Prophet, like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is saying these words, and Allah is pledging to enter us into the Jannah only if we establish salah, and if we fail to enter Jannah, who is responsible for us? Us. This dunya is a test for us. Brothers and sisters, make sure you establish 5 times of prayer. Make sure you are here in this masjid. MashaAllah, this is my first time in this masjid. I see this is a very blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon all of you, that there is a school, there is a class going on. There are a lot of activities for you people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may bless those who are behind all these activities. Brothers and sisters, all we need is to do some, to have a strong intention. Inshallah, when we have intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gives us tawfiq. If you are performing 5 times prayer in the masjid behind Imam, this is not your power. You should not be proud of yourselves that I am one of the musalloon. I am establishing salah. This is tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without the tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot do anything. So we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us the life, who has given us the wealth, who has given us the health, and who has given us the time that we can perform prayer and please Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Due to the short of time, I want to stop here because the asr is also very short. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in our life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us hidayah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me tawfiq to follow whatever I say, and give you tawfiq to follow whatever I say. And if I have said something wrong, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you as well. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين استغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وله الحمد في الآخرة وهو الحكيم الخبير يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو الرحيم الغفور. الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو الحكيم الخبير يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو الرحيم الغفور. الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يكن له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا. وقال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وبارك وصلي وسلم عليه. اللهم بارك على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وبارك وصلي وسلم عليه وبارك وصلي وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى كل ملائكة المقربين وعلى عباد الله الصالحين وعلى أهل طاعتك منهم أجمعين. اللهم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. وصلى الله تبارك وتعالى على خير خلقه نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين واتل ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر وأقم الصلاة.